For deer management, Florida's rules are a little different than other states. But that doesn't stop the Crazy On crew from putting meat in the freezer and getting the job done.
I got a jacked up Dodge with a 6-inch lift. I'm a crazy redneck, full buddy's got my back. Makes a little bit of wild, a little dumb. Stir it on up and let it run. Get your crazy on, run it all night long till the break of dawn. Crazy on, drop them dead on the ground. Running dogs from a buggy, bulldogs and hounds. You either got it in your blood or you don't. Get your crazy on.
Another great hunt.
It's crazy on.
Florida's a little different than most states. We only have 1 week during the general gun season that we can harvest does. So when that week gets here, we shift from hunting the bucks into putting the management time in on the does.
So I have this ground blind set up, and these does have been filtering down this road every day, feeding down this road. There's been a bunch of acorns dropping. The road's lined with oaks, so these deer are in there every day. There's a couple big fat does coming in there, so I'm gonna get my bow, I'm gonna hit that blind, and hopefully get one for the freezer.
We're here this morning, really just to kill a doe. We've been pretty bad on our doe management here this year, so. Today's intent is to kill one, so I know there's a bunch of them coming in here. We got a little Antler King food plot right here, just on this road. Got this ground blind set up for the kids, and so I figured we'd just come in here, sit in it, and whack us a doe if they come in. Oh, we just smoked that doe. We only have a week of doe week here, and just opened today, and we need some meat in our freezer, and we need to do our part to manage these does on our piece of property. We didn't kill any during bow season, so couldn't be happier about that. That's awesome. Heart shot, I don't think she went very far at all. She was pumping blood, so. Another doe down, another deer in the freezer. Awesome.
Good job.
You don't think these executioners are a killer machine? Look at this blood trail.
Definitely an easy blood trail to follow.
Big old doe.
Man, we couldn't ask for a better hunt this morning. It's the start of doe days for us. We only get a few days during the actual deer season outside of archery season to harvest these does, and we didn't do our part during bow season. We're too worried about these bucks, and because here our bucks rut during the archery season, and we kind of stayed off of the does. But now it's time to fill the freezer and try to fill some tags. So I couldn't be happier with this old doe. Got a bunch of white on her face, just a good old doe. So should be good to eat, and we're doing our part to manage, and you can't beat old heart shot. I don't care what, how many big bucks you killed or what, but I still get excited over these does. It doesn't even matter. It doesn't matter if they have horns or not. If I know I'm about to release an arrow, I get pumped up, and just very thankful to be able to come out here and hunt these deer and bring them home and, you know, fill the freezer up with them. I just can't be any happier about that. Randy did an awesome job filming it today, and thankful for that too.
I still can't believe how much blood was on the ground from the executioner broadhead. That's why you gotta choose a broadhead that's got a big cut diameter, that's razor sharp, that you know when you shoot, it's gonna do some damage.
Crazy On Outdoors is brought to you by Crystal Automotive. The clear choice is Crystal Automotive. Bill Jordan's Realtree, family, friends, and the outdoors. Hipstick, designed to hunt. Executioner broadheads, born to kill. BG Products, making cars and trucks last longer and perform better. Antler King, bigger bucks, healthier deer. Modular driven technologies, engineered accuracy. Cowboys Barbecue and Steak Company, Expedition Archery. Jeb's Chokes, Garmin. By Lethal Human Scent Elimination. And by Pecker Wrecker Calls.
Come on, man, what are you doing? We gotta go.
I can't go. Transmission went out of my truck. I'm gonna take every penny I saved to get it fixed.
You might be in luck. Call your mechanic right now and ask him if you're covered under the BG Lifetime Protection Plan.
No, I never paid for any protection plans.
That's where you're wrong. If your shop's using quality BG products, then you're covered for free. Just call your service shop, ask if you're covered, and make sure to get BG approval before starting any work.
All right, great, thanks. Looks like I can go hunting after all, thanks to BG.
Chad Parker has already capitalized on the short doe season here in Florida and put some meat in the freezer. Now he's heading out with his girlfriend Randy to let her sling some arrows of her own.
We're all set up for our afternoon hunt. It's doe week here in Florida. We're gonna be doing some management on some does primarily. October here in Florida. We're hunting on the edge of the field here. It's doe week. We're going to try to do some doe management. If a buck comes out, we'll just go ahead and take him. But crossing our fingers for either one is our main goal.
So this old mature doe is pretty much in bow range now, and she's feeding right down the edge of this field. And I hear Randy draw her bow back, and I'm waiting for her to shoot. and it's nothing. So I'm poking my head around the camera, keep looking, and I can see that she's having trouble with that peep sight.
The doe came in perfect, drew back 3 different times. The peep, I just couldn't get it turned straight. Missed the opportunity. Happens, I guess.
So it's starting to get dark, and I can see Rainey starting to lose a little bit of hope. But just then, she tells me there's a deer coming, and it looks like a buck.
There's a buck right this way.
Looks like that peep may have been a blessing in disguise. This doe has drawn a buck out into the field, and this management hunt just became a trophy hunt.
I just shot my first buck ever with a bow. Yes! I can't believe that deer just came in here. It's actually one of the ones we watched this summer. He's actually just trying to fight another buck down here. I cannot believe that just happened.
So with it being late in the evening and knowing that shot was a little far back, we watched the tape and we watched it over and over just to make sure that we knew where that arrow went in, her angle. And we know it's a lethal shot. It's just a matter of how much penetration we had. So we know the best thing to do is let that deer lay overnight. We'll come back in the morning, hopefully pick up blood and find her deer. So it was a long sleepless night, but we got out there the next morning. We picked up blood right away and we followed that deer for about 400 yards till we lost blood. We spent the next 2 days looking hard for that deer. We brought dog in and we scattered out and we never saw another sight of that deer. Never found any more blood, hair, nothing, no indication to us that that deer was dead. The shot looked lethal, but judging by the penetration, looking at the arrow, we're starting to have our doubts that maybe we didn't have enough penetration. It was a little far back, even though it was a quarter shot, her bow might not have enough poundage on it to push it all the way through. So it's always disappointing. I know Randy was upset, and I was upset too that we didn't get that buck. And a couple weeks later, I was in there scouting a new spot, and it was probably 400 or 500 yards from where we last stopped. And I thought I smelled something dead. I started to investigate, and you know, of course, it popped in my mind that it could be Randy's deer. So I walked real hard and looked for about 2 hours, and finally walked up on this deer, and it was definitely her buck. He was wasted, which the coyotes pretty much ate them all up, but they left the horns for us, and Rainey was able to put her hands on that deer.
Rainey was brokenhearted not finding that deer that she shot that day. But in the end, she was able to put her hands on the set of antlers of her first bow buck kill.
This is the new Realtree X.
Realtree Max 5. This is the new Max 1 XT.
These are the most realistic patterns that we've ever developed. These patterns set the standard in effectiveness and versatility.
This new Max 1 XT
may help someone get close to a trophy bull.
We know how much you cherish the outdoors.
I love the outdoors.
And that's why we put so much into your camo pattern.
Realtree, your family of camo patterns.
At Crystal Automotive in Homosassa, Florida, we offer a full line of commercial vehicles. From cargo vans to cabin chassis, upfitted with dump bodies to refrigerated boxes, rancher beds to utility beds, Crystal can do unlimited modifications to any vehicle. Don't have a fleet account? Crystal will get you one. Need a loan in your business name? Crystal will secure it for you. We understand how important your equipment is to your business, and we have the experience to get it right. Call Crystal today and let us start designing your next commercial vehicle.
The Crazy On crew has been working hard to manage their properties. By harvesting the appropriate number of does, establishing tons of Antler King food plots and mineral sites, and by passing younger bucks and allowing them to reach full maturity, they are seeing great results all over the state here in Florida. Now, Justin Lamb is headed to spend a little time on the edge of one of those Antler King plots that had been obliterated by the deer to see if he can cash in on all that hard work.
Well, now it's my turn. Doe week's over. I'm hoping all this management paid off, and I'm looking for a trophy.
We came up here to our good buddy Nick's place. We spent a lot of time up here with him this year, putting food plots in, you know, filling protein feeders, filling the corn feeders year-round, trying to manage his deer herd he's got here. Nick is a fanatic about feeding year-round, feeding protein, and just quality deer managing his herd. So we're going to sit here tonight, beautiful evening, and see if we can't get us a good buck on the ground.
There's one big 10 point that we've been getting trail camera pictures of and seen just a few times at a distance during archery season. So we're hoping to get lucky and have that deer come out tonight. So today it started off kind of slow. We seen a couple of does and a little buck, and you know, next thing we know, we look up and there that big 10 point was.
That's a shooter. He's a shooter for sure.
Get your crazy on every day. Look for us online.
In today's hunting world, you probably have your hands full in the woods. From calls and rangefinders to scents and scent eliminators, most hunters would rather sacrifice a little accuracy rather than carry a shooting stick. HipStick solves that. Rock solid stability combined with hassle-free portability. HipStick is designed to hunt. Carry it right on your belt, then use it in the field to steady your rifle, pistol, crossbow, or even binos. Make your shot count. Shoot from the hip with HipStick.
Crazy On Outdoors is brought to you by Crystal Automotive. The clear choice is Crystal Automotive. Bill Jordan's Realtree. Family, friends, and the outdoors. HipStick. Designed to hunt. Executioner Broadheads. Born to kill. BG Products, making cars and trucks last longer and perform better. Antler King, bigger bucks, healthier deer. Modular Driven Technologies, engineered accuracy. Cowboys Barbecue and Steak Company, Expedition Archery. Jeb's Chokes, Garmin. By Lethal Human Scent Elimination. And by Pecker Wrecker Calls. Justin Lamb is deer hunting in Florida. And a buck that he's been crossing his fingers for all year just walked out.
take them.
That's what I'm talking about. Got a stud on the ground. Let's go check them out.
Got your stud right there.
Slob, son. Could not be happier about this right here. It was hot. We were nervous. Plan come together. These good food plots we put in a few months ago. You can see they paid off. That high shoulder shot gets them every time.
I just cannot believe this all came together this weekend. We hadn't been up here in a couple weeks. We knew it was gonna be hot, but it was opening weekend of gun season. We were coming no matter what. We spent a lot of time helping get these food plots in with Nick and feeding these deer protein all year long. And as you can see, it paid off for us today. This is an incredible buck for me. This couldn't have played out any better. We spent half the summer up with our good buddy Nick, planting food plots, helping him feed protein, which we do year round. Decided to come up for opening weekend of gun season, got a little time off. Made the trip up and it was hot. We knew it was gonna be hot all weekend. We had a full moon. We didn't know what the deer were gonna be doing. But luckily me and Chad persistent paid off, got in the stand this afternoon and shot a monster of a 10 point. I tell you, I couldn't be any more proud of this buck.
So no matter what part of the season it is, it can always be fun, whether you're just managing does or you're chasing that trophy buck that you've been after.
We can really start to see that our management programs are starting to pay off here in Florida, and we are excited to be able to get our crazy on in these woods.
I'm gonna need more than that.
Huh?
I'm gonna need more than that.
Are you gonna talk more than that?
Yeah. I don't think you got tracked very far, but first we break this off, there ain't no video next.
That'll work. That's a wrap.